Spain.
Spain, no Portugal. No worries.
Same.
Iberian Peninsula. We are going to present a relevant source of digital paleoanthropological dataset for Ariane Plus. In 2013, we were as observers in the kickoff meeting of Ariadne in Rome. We saw in this meeting the opportunity to be part in future projects and understand that the Thenié role in paleoanthropology could be useful for this area. So thanks to Franco Nicolucci and for the people who invited us to that meeting in Rome in 2013, and now thanks to the opportunity to be part in Ariadne Plus and to be here in the CCR Congress. The first thing is to know what is Thenié. Thenié is the National Research Center on Human Evolution. And its mission is twofold. First is conducting world-class multidisciplinary research in paleoanthropology and quaternary sciences, focusing on human biological and cultural evolution worldwide. And two, providing services to the field of social and quaternary sciences, as well as to the technological and industrial communities at large. And how are organized these two missions? The research in the center is carried out through three main programs: hominid paleobiology, that is focused on hominid biological evolution, taxonomy, and phylogeny; geology and geochronology, that is focused in studies related to stratigraphy, site formation processes, and paleoenvironmental reconstruction, dating the deposit yielding human and cultural remains, and using various dating techniques; and archaeology, that is focused on stone tool technology manufacture and use; bone taphonomy and zooarchaeology, fauna and analysis, spatial archaeology, and land use. So regarding to this first mission, where are we working? We are working in different parts of the world, in Africa, Asia, Europe, and South America. Some of these archaeological sites are clue to the study of human evolution and the dispersion of hominid from Africa to the rest of the world. In Spain, at present, we are working in 18 archaeological and paleontological sites, some of them so important, like Atapuerca is very close to our center in Thenié, only at 14 kilometers from our center, Maltravieso or Bolomo. In relation with one of the goals of the center is the transfer of knowledge. In 2018, we participated in 228 publications. 74 include in the Science Citation Index. Ariadne Plus will allow us to transfer the multidisciplinary information that is generated in every archaeopaleontological studies and project, and organize all this information in dataset to be useful for other new projects for researchers and for the scientific community, especially for the paleoanthropological community, but open to other research areas too. This is our center, and I would like to show you the center in 50 seconds in a video. Thank you. So this is a virtual visit, but if you pass through Burgos, you are invited to visit us in our center too. What is CENIE? CENIE is ICTS. ICTS refers to facilities, resources, or services for the development of top quality cutting edge research, as well as the communication, exchange, and preservation of knowledge, the transfer of technology, and promotion of innovation. The ICTS are located throughout the country and are displayed on the map of unique scientific and technical infrastructure and belong to other networks in Europe. These facilities are unique or exceptional in their fields, with a high cost of investment, maintenance, and operation, and are of a strategic importance that justify the availability of all actors in the field of research, development, and innovation. Have three fundamental characteristics are public ownership, unique for their facilities, and open to competitive access. Due to the labs and the facilities in the center, the Spanish government includes CENIE into the ICTS in 2009. That is the moment that the laboratories start their activity. And we are the only one dedicated to social sciences and humanities. At the Andel Plus, for us, is another way to give add value to the ICTS, especially to provide services into the field of social and quaternary science and paleoanthropology community. Our catalog of services include different labs, digital mapping and 3D analysis. The activities of this lab are focused on fieldwork, cartography, reconstruction, and spatial analysis of geological and archaeological elements. Among its products are particularly Northwind, geological and geomorphological cartography, paleogeographic reconstruction, analysis of spatial patterns, or 3D reconstructions. These activities, which take place both in field or inside caves, for example, can cover temporal sequences. Thus, the digitalization, reconstruction, and analysis of natural and cultural heritage can also be approached for a 4D perspective. Other laboratories are material characterization labs composed by geology labs, archaeometry labs, and microscopy and micro-CT labs. Geology labs include thin section and soil micromorphology and area of sample preparation and sedimentology. The archaeometry laboratory is for characterization of material based on the study of their chemical and mineralogical composition and their vibrational and thermal analysis, and have all the equipment to conduct non-invasive analysis, so it is not necessary the prior physical or chemical preparation of the sample, so it's non-destructive analysis. And there is also portable equipment for file use. In microscopy, we have optical microscopy, confocal laser microscopy, electron microscopy, and we have micro CT that is a micro CT scan. Geochronology labs are composed by four different techniques, in all cases, the researchers and the technicians can do the complete process for field work to the age calculation. Archaeomagnetins boasts all the necessary instruments for the study of magnetic properties of rocks in order to develop magnetostatigraphies in sediments. The 2G magnetometer, the laboratory's main piece, enables the automatic measurement of standard samples and unchanneled probes up to 150 cm in length as the basis for chronostatigraphic studies. Electron spin resonance dating mainly devotes the dating geological and archaeological material such as tooth enamel or quartz grains extracted from sediment. Luminescent dating is based to the ability of certain minerals, especially quartz and feldspar, to accumulate electrical charge. And depending on the technique, we can have three different techniques, TL, OSL, or IRSL. And uranium series conduct research work and implement service involving multi-elemental and isotopic analysis on different types of materials. Collection, conservation, and restoration. One of the roles of CENIE is the curation of the collection stored therein. As a result of excavation at archaeological and paleontological sites, one of the goals is to store the Atapuerca collections. This year, we have received more than 40,000 items of this site from the Burgos Museum to add to the Cenie collection. It is hoped that such collection will steadily expand with the entry of more and more archaeological and paleontological remains from different excavations, particularly those linked to projects carried out by the center's team. It therefore boasts facilities that are suitable for the storage of a large volume of pieces, ensuring optimal condition for their long-term duration. What is this? Ah, it's here. That is his, this. COAC is the comparative anatomy and osteological collection that includes specimens belonging to recent species and also casts of quaternary fossils, particularly casts on human fossils from any geographical region and time period. The experimental tracheology collection brings together tools made from different raw materials which have been used on an experimental basis in different activities related to prehistoric ways of life. And the mineral collection, that is little, is under development with the purpose of accommodating petrological samples of material that have been used or that may have been used to create stone tools during the Paleolithic period. This is the conservation and restoration labs. And with all these labs, what kind of data are we producing? I'm going to go quickly with these slides because we are showing this during the morning. We produce all these type of information in the different labs, 3D, reconstruction, photos in optical, confocal, and electrode, 3D models. In this case, this is the micro CT, this is a radiography. In the field world, we can obtain gamma spectrometry. This is for Lito and set that we obtain all this type of database with a lot of information that we complete with photos and draws and a video, but I don't have time, so the important thing is this. How are we planning to manage all this information? We have the idea to use the our first idea for collection. So we have planned to do something like this. This is the central box when you have ID. ID number, spending number, and here you can put other information related with this item, that could be field work, publication, taxonomic, report, restoration process, images, everything that we can produce in the labs. So the plan, all these things are these. We are new in the project, so we are launching the hiring process for assistant engineering that finished in the 18th of April. So we expect to have someone working with us as soon as possible. Purchasing the equipment server that now we are in the legal process to acquire the equipment. Inventorying the paleoanthropological data, which will be shared. We are making a list of all information that we want to share and include the files and information explained during this presentation. And something very important is establishing the guidelines with which describe the different types of data for digital access. And all this from now to summertime. In this slide, the only thing that I want to say is that Ariane Plus is not a lonely project. It's related with other projects in the center. Some of them we are developing now. This is the expansion of osteological collection with European funds. This is TENIE funds. This is the development DITIC collection. This is the reference dental collection, Raton Pérez. It's funds by TENIE and other private and public funds. This is the scanning items from reference collection with micro CT and laser scanner with TENIE funds. And obviously the TENIE research results and laboratory data. So to conclude, is as an Ariane Plus partner, TENIE will enhance the European digital archaeological infrastructure with valuable paleoanthropological and geochronological data set covering the prehistoric periods as well as disciplines and regions that were lacking data set in the previous Ariadne. And thank you for your attention and your patience.